Hey, Grace Church, I hope that you enjoyed dinner tonight. We're going to continue the series in the book of Hebrews, and today we're looking at chapter 6, which is one of the most difficult chapters in all the Bible. I want to read this to you because it sounds pretty crazy. In verse 4, it says, "It is impossible for those who have once been enlightened, who've tasted the heavenly gift, who've shared in the Holy Spirit, who've tasted the goodness of the Word of God and the powers of the age to come, and who have fallen away to be brought back to repentance. To their loss, they are crucifying the Son of God all over again and subjecting him to public disgrace. Land that drinks the rain, often falling on it, and it produces the crop useful to the house for those who farm to receive the blessing of God. But the land that produces thorns and thistles is worthless and is in danger of being cursed. In the end, it will be burned." So, this is the Bible warning us. The good news is the Bible is full of warnings and full of assurance. In Hebrews chapter 6, the pastor who's written this sermon is warning his church that there should be a certain urgency about our faith that cannot be taken lightly. But we have to see this in the broader context. And here's just the basic way I explained it. That our hearts should do four things. That we should respond in faith, we should mature in faith, we should train in faith, and we should endure in faith. What that means is when we first hear the gospel, it is our responsibility to respond to the gospel, to submit our lives to Jesus as Lord, to turn over our authority and give it to Jesus and say, "Now you run my life. All that I have is yours." And that's our response in faith. But that's not a one and done thing. From there, we mature in faith. Hebrews 6 says, "Let us move past the elementary teachings. The foundation has been laid. It's time for us to grow." He uses the illustration of meat versus bottled milk. I think all of us could agree that it's weird at certain ages to be drinking bottled milk. It's time to move on to solid food. It's time to mature and grow. And so listen, church, God expects you to mature. He expects you to develop. He expects you to move from where you are to where he has for you. He wants that for you and is inviting you into that. And three, it's train in faith. This is not try, this is train. These are different things. Training is consistent. It's doing something today that enables me to do even more tomorrow. It's saying no matter what's going on, I'm headed towards a goal. I want to achieve something. This isn't momentary action. This isn't inspiration. This is I'm committed. I'm going to give myself to this to be transformed because I am in a process. 1 Timothy 4:7, Paul tells young Timothy, train yourself to be godly. This is going to take effort and it's going to take action. And so then the last thing is endure in faith. What the author of Hebrews is telling us is that the gospel is not just initially important. The gospel is primarily important. It is the central feature of your life now and you must endure. And so what we said is that saving faith is staying faith. It's sticking around. And so I think it would be wise for us all to heed the warning of this text that says it is possible to experience spiritual things and not know Jesus. It's possible to go to church and take communion and pray the prayer and worship and sing and have all these experiences and not know Jesus. But if we are people who've responded to the gospel or training ourselves and maturing in the gospel, we will endure. And in the end, we will know Jesus and we will love him. So church, my prayer for us is that we would both be passionate and persevering, that we would have inside of us a desire to know him and love him and be drawn to him and also to persevere and make it to the end. Be wise today to heed the warning and be wise today to live in the assurance that it's his faithfulness we trust, not our faithfulness. And so church, if we can do that, I look forward to the conversations we're going to have now. So I want to turn it over to your house church leader to keep the conversation going.